see, monkey do. Monkey see, monkey do. Monkey see, monkey do. Monkey see, monkey do, monkey. Monkey say, monkey do. Monkey say, monkey do. Monkey say, monkey do. Monkey say, monkey do.
Wherever the deeds of Sri Rama are sung, in all such places does Hanuman cry tears of devotion and joy. In all such places does his presence remove the fear of demons. Eons ago, in another life, Hanuman, a great, powerful, hairy deity, vanquished one such demon. Now in 2010, reincarnated, and rip-roaring for some banana-flavored revenge, the demon king Ravana has challenged the powerful monkey god to a rematch. Today, 60 Minutes follows the eighth path leading to this epic battle. And despite evidence to the contrary, this is no monkey business. Hanuman has agreed to take a few minutes out of his rigorous training exercise to speak with 60 Minutes. Let's talk superpowers. Some have considered you the Superman of Hinduism. Do you care to comment? Interesting. Well, we've located your parents, reincarnated version of your parents, that is, and I believe they are local high school teachers. Do you have anything to say to them? What was it like raising Hanuman?
It was tough. It was hard being a full-time wind god and a father to a monkey at the same time. Lots of bananas and monkey business. Literally.
Hanuman was a very mischievous child. He had issues with authority, listening, rules. For example, one time he tried to eat the sun.
To his credit, he was persistent. Once he chased the fiery devil all the way to Indra's place. Remember that?
I remember.
Yeah,
absolutely. Indra?
The Lord of Heaven wore storms, pretty much everything.
Yeah, Indra wasn't too happy about the sun orange incident. In my opinion, he kind of overreacted by striking my little baby with a lightning bolt.
But what can you do? Your kid thought it was a piece of fruit. A monkey, for Brahman's sake.
What issues did you face having a powerful, immortal monkey god as a child?
I mean, not many people can say they've done that. How'd that all work out for you?
Hanuman did not play well with others. He was always playing tricks on the spirits of the forest.
I mean, he'd always pull out his powers every time he didn't get his way. He was a stubborn kid.
You could say Hanuman abused his powers. It was to the point where the other gods were pretty fed up and begged Brahma to punish Hanuman.
Brahma brought down the iron fist on the little dynamo. His punishment, he took his way his knowledge of powers.
Oh, and for the record, yeah. I hope you don't think that we're the type of celebrity parents who don't punish their children. We took away his strength. We took away his courage for 2 weeks, which, to my understanding, is the modern equivalent of, say, Xbox and TV.
Hanuman, did you know that Indian villagers venerate you as a protective boundary guardian? Also, that the Jakku Temple is dedicated to your awesomeness?
and people pray to you to be liberated from their afflictions? Oh, also, did you know that there's an 85-foot statue of you in India? I'm here with Rama, Hanuman's old pal, and he's agreed to share some stories. First question, how did you meet Hanuman?
My first encounter with Hanuman? Ravana. He was king of Lanka, basically the biggest of the baddies. Think Hindu Darth Vader with Shiva being that old wrinkly dude. Anyway, Ravana. He captured my wife Sita and Hanuman decided to help me vanquish him.
How'd that go, you know, the vanquishing and whatnot?
You know, pretty well. Hanuman was basically the Tom Cruise of the Veneras, those sent to help save my girl.
How? Crazy, unstable?
You know, Mission Impossible is what they called their task. But nothing could stop old Hanuman. He outsmarted the sea god Sureza by changing his shape. He took out demon after demon, he stomped on their city, and he finally caught the rascal, but...
Did he submit? No, I think not. But I got my wife back, and Ravana got what he deserved.
How did you honor Hanuman for all of his good deeds?
Yeah, you know, after the battle, I was handing out rewards, you know, eternal glory, everlasting fame, free iPods. But Hanuman was a humbled old monkey, and he didn't want any of that. My wife gave him a necklace. It symbolized his adoration and devotion to me. And that was important because Hanuman was so much more than a monkey to do my dirty work. He was a friend.
Random question. What was your favorite pastime?
Man, other than Monkey in the Middle, I had to be kicking the untouchable.
The story will continue in a moment.
Hanuman, you've beaten him before. Can you do it again?
Okay.
Look, folks, a demon approaches. Take millennia to establish a victor. It's definitely not a fight that can be covered in 60 minutes. We hope you learned a valuable lesson with this segment, not solely the history and actions of this great monkey deity, but perhaps the significance of that history and of his actions. I'm Will Thuninger, and this is...
Hey, I'm trying to wrap this up.
Oh, it looks like you vanquished the demon sooner than I thought. Any final comments?